Okay, so as those questions come through, I'm going to kick it off right here, Tate. I mean, for you, kind of going from that first hire of full-time executive assistant to where you're at now, I can't remember if you shared the time frame, but like, what are you looking back on it? Like, what are one or two things that you've already noticed? Like, wow, I would not have been able to do this had I not made that move.
Yeah, 100%. So for me, I didn't realize what a subconscious stressor calendar management was. Like even this webinar, I think I don't know if it was this webinar, but in any case, things pop up all the time where it's like, hey, can you do this? Like, let's set up a time. And there's always this back and forth and I'm checking my schedule and I'm going, I don't know, like, are the margins okay here? And even just taking that off my plate and having someone else, I've completely offloaded calendar management. Like Elizabeth owns my calendar. I will throw things in there for sure. Like if something comes up, but she owns the calendar. So if someone emails me, I just respond with her CC and I say, hey, tying in my assistant. Thanks so much. And then they go back and forth, figure out a time that works because she knows what my margins are on when I have to fly, when, you know, how soon before a flight I need to be, you know, hard stop so that I can get ready and go to the airport. She knows all this stuff, right? So once you set up that system, that was just huge, really a weight lifted off my shoulders that I didn't realize was so heavy until it went away. And then, yeah, I mean, if you are constantly burdened with the administrative stuff, you can't build up, right? You just cannot work on your business, on expanding and growing and doing all the things that you need to do to grow your business if you're doing bookkeeping. Like it just, and there's, like I said, with those tennis balls, right? There's some of those tennis balls only you can return, but a lot of them, you can show someone else how to return or very, very easily, or even in the example of bringing on our CFO, Jim Morales, there are tennis balls that he is much better suited to return than me. So it starts to become a delegate and divide and conquer, and you can just all move so much faster as an organization. Yeah.
Man, the calendar piece, that sounds, you know, it's something as soon as you started saying it, I'm like, I'm thinking that I'm getting to where I want to be with that. And then there's a few things you just said right there. I'm like, man, I got to level that up now. Cause I can only imagine that's so powerful. So thank you.